Hey y'all, welcome back to L&L Honeycomb Homestead. Today is going to be a special day for a special person. Her name is CAMI'S Cannon, okay? You can follow her over on Facebook. I have her name right here. See it? CAMI'S Cannon, okay? This is going to be a great special day because I am going to be canning CAMI'S grandmother's recipe. She gave me this recipe and she says, share it for everybody. So everybody that's watching this channel, the ones that are subscribed to this channel, y'all are gonna get this recipe. So down there in the comments down below, you will see everything that I've used in this video, okay? From the seasonings and the vegetables, okay? All of that, okay? And then I'm going to can this up, and you can do it too, because I'm going to walk you through it. I'll walk you through it. So, y'all, if y'all want to know what this recipe is, and it's so delicious, stay tuned. The Brussels sprouts. Okay, so as you can see, family, we got stuff from the garden. We've got our zucchini, we got some bell peppers, and we have some sweet peppers. We have that okra. You remember I said I was going to save as much as I can. So we got that, and we cut that up. We've got multicolored potatoes, and you already know I had my little potatoes and some red potatoes, but I went and got some purple potatoes. Okay, and then we have our little miniature carrots. We've got some homegrown green beans, okay? And then we have that corn. Y'all knew I grew that corn. That's all I had left because we've been tearing that corn up. So I saved this for the recipe too. And then we have us some eggplant, right? We have us here some onion, some Roma tomatoes because everything was in the freezer, remember, so don't look at the tomatoes and say, ew, no, it's been frozen, so it's done thawed out a little bit. And the star, the cabbage, okay? So let's get started with this soup. Family, so you're going to take all of those beautiful vegetables, you're going to put them all in a good stock pot, okay? The last thing you're going to put on there is the tomatoes, but you're going to put it on high, and you're going to let this cook on down, and then we're going to add the tomatoes when it drops down a little bit, okay? And remember, your vegetables are going to make its own stock, okay? Like their juices, okay? Because it's going to break down, and then you have your vegetable stock already in there, okay? So we're going to let this cook down, and I'll come back once we do that. Hey family, so you see how it's cooked down some, because you got it up on high, or medium high anyway. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and add the tomatoes. And now we're getting ready to coordinate all, incorporate everything together. Just put everything together and just kind of stir it all up. Just like this. And you will see that the broth and all that is off in here. And it's going to cook on down. And that's what you want it to do. You want it to cook on down. And so when it gets down a little bit more, I'll come back. Okay, family, as you can see, I took it off the stove because we cooked it down. And another thing is, you already know, the hawk. You know how he do. He had to come in here. He knew I was getting ready to can this soup up. But we have enough soup, and I'm grateful. So now I'm going to can the rest of this soup up. And so that way you can see them in the jars and look how pretty everything is. So let's go ahead and jar these up. Okay, family, as you can see here, I'm sorry I don't have my mic on. It died on me. So here you're going to need a jar lifter for your supplies. You're going to also need a funnel. I'm going to be using this measuring cup and this ladle so I can fill my jars up. You're going to need a debubbler. And on that debubbler, you're going to have your little measurements so that way you can see where your measure is going to be as far as like your liquids or your food product. It'll let you know how much you need to put in your jars, okay? You're going to also need a magnet. This magnet is going to help you be able to dip your lids up out of the warm, hot water, okay? So you're going to need those, okay? So let's jar it up. Let's jar it up. Okay, y'all, so I already have a few jars in the pot, and I just want to give you a demonstration on how you would do this. So you're going to have your funnel, and the ingredients, as far as the seasonings, are already in this pot. You're going to have your, make sure everything is hot when you're doing this, okay? This is a hot method, right? Your jars are hot, everything. And I'll come back and explain all that to you. So everything is hot. The jars are hot. Make sure you don't burn yourself. And the soup is hot. And down in the description box below, you will have all of the ingredients that I used and the seasonings I used. Okay? This, I'll tell you more about this recipe after I show you all this. Okay? So you're going to go up to a 1-inch head space, okay? 1 inch. Okay, so I'm going to go to the next jar. And we're going to fill this on up. 1-inch head space. And this soup smells good. Okay? Now, when it's gotten too full, just like this, when it's too full, see that? I have a spoon. Let me get it. You get a spoon, and what you do is you're going to just scoop some of this stuff out. Put it back in the pot. Okay? You don't have to dump the whole jar out. You're going to just scoop out some of the soup or whatever you have in your container, okay? And you're gonna just bring it to that 1-inch headspace, and that's right here. You see the spoon? Put it right here at that line right there, that first line. Okay, that's your 1-inch headspace, okay? Okay, the next thing you're gonna do is get your debubbler. And I have my debubbler, I just had it. Okay, there it is. You're going to get your debubbler, and you're going to debubble. You want to get all the air pockets out, okay? Just like so. You're going to do the other side, the other one, okay? Now, when you debubble and get the air pockets out, it's going to bring your liquid levels down. With this, it's still at the 1-inch head space. But if it do go down, you would just bring your fluid right back to whatever head space is asking for. Okay? And that's how you would debubble. All right. So now we're done with the debubbling. Now we're getting ready to wipe through the jars. Okay, so we got our vinegar. I got my little towel here. I'm gonna dip that with that vinegar. And you watch out, it's hot. Okay, so we're gonna go around the rims of the jar. This is when you're gonna find out or feel one at a time. You're gonna check it when you're washing them. You're gonna check the rims, okay? And see if you got any cracks in it. This is another way in checking too, because you wanna make sure that when you wipe these, you're checking them. You're gonna make sure that all the grease or whatever you are putting in your jars and stuff, you wanna make sure that that lid is clean, because you wanna be able to make sure your lids adhere to the mouth of this jar. Because if you don't do this, then it's not gonna cause it, it's not gonna seal for you, okay? It won't seal because it needs to be clean. So make sure you wipe the jars, okay? Make sure you wipe them. So now that you've seen that it was wiped down, the next thing we're going to do is put our lids on, okay? And we're gonna put our lids on. See how it holds the magnet, holds that. How you get it off, you just put your finger in the center and then let up. Okay? Now we're gonna put our bands on. With our bands, you wanna do it fingertip tight. You don't wanna crank on it and make it really hard like that. You just want to do it fingertip tight. And we're gonna take it on over to the pot, and I'm gonna show you from there what we do next. Family, so as you can see, I have 8 pints in my pressure cooker, okay, pressure canner, okay? You want that water to be also hot, okay? Because your jars are hot, your item is hot, okay, the product, that's hot. You want everything to be hot, because if you put cold with hot, it's going to cause your jars to crack. So it needs to look just like that, okay? And then I'm going to show you the lid. Okay, here's the lid. All right, with this lid, you have your vent where the steam comes out of, okay? You have your vent gauge right here, your steam gauge. And with that, you want to be able to look right through that hole. There's a little pinhole right here. You want to be able to see that pinhole right through it, okay? If there is something in there or something's caused it to clog, it will not be able to vent. So you want to make sure you can see over through there. How? Just pull it up like this and you'll look right through it. And if you can see right through it, then you know that it's clear, okay? The next thing you want to have, you want to make sure that band that's in here, see that black band? Now you can oil that a little bit. It don't have to be sopping oiled, but you can get it oiled a little bit, and that's what's going to help you be able to take that off your pot, okay? That's going to help you, all right? You want to keep that good and oiled. Okay, the next thing you want to do is have your little thing here. You see how that thing is moving right here? Right here. It's going to go up and down right here, okay? So you want to make sure that it's working, okay? See that? The way I'm holding it. You want to see it, see? You want to make sure that it's working, okay? Because this right here, when it's reaching that temperature, it's going to pop up. And then after the pressure is down, it's going to drop down just like this. So you want to make sure that's working pretty good. You want to check all that stuff before you even start canning. You want to make sure everything is pretty good for you, okay? And then, here, Let me show you. Let me turn it on around. Okay, here you will see there's an arrow. I'm trying to bring it up close if you can see it. There's an arrow somewhere right around here. Okay, that arrow is going to show you where at on your canner, where the other one is, where you line that up. That's how you're going to be able to close it. That's how you're going to align it with that pot. This lid is going to align right with that pot. So I'm going to demonstrate that to you so that way you'll know. If you're new on the channel, I'm going to show, just like I've been showing the other videos, I'm going to let you know that so that way you'll know, okay? So I'm going to show you that. So hold that thumb. Okay, so here I'm getting ready to put the pot on so you can see the lid is aligned right with this. And it's going to plop right down. Did you see that? So now we're going to close it up. It's good and closed to make sure your pot is aligned with your stove eye. Okay, you want it to be even. Now that it's all on there, now we're getting ready to churn up the heat. If you got gas, that's what they usually say. If you got electric, turn it up on high. Now that it's turned up on high, this right here is what you're going to be looking for. So as it's starting to build up pressure, okay, pressure is your heat. It's going to build up pressure in here because everything is closed up. It's going to start venting steam out of this right here. That steam is going to have a flow coming out, okay? And when it's a steady flow, then you're just going to set your timer for 10 minutes. If it's pumping, what I mean by that, if it's puckering and then it's not like a steady flow of steam, give it a minute because you want it to be a steady flow where it's steady going and flowing, okay? That's when you set your timer for 10 minutes, okay? So I'm going to bring you back here when that happens because it's got to build its pressure, okay? So stay tuned. Okay, family, so I'm back. It is now venting really good. And so now we're getting ready to set this timer for 10 minutes. And we're going to let it vent for 10 minutes. And after it finished venting, I'm going to show you what we do next, okay? So let this vent for 10 minutes. Okay, family, the time is up. Now, I have my 15-pound gauge here. I'm going to put it right here on the top. Now, we're going to the second phase. Now, we're getting ready to start processing our food. For my elevation, if you want to know where your elevation is or how to know what your elevation is, you're going to go on Google and you will type up down below on the screen. I will show you what is my elevation. There you will put in your zip code. Okay? It will tell you what your elevation is. That's going to determine what your PSIs are going to be. So in my area, since I have a 15-pound weight gauge and my elevation is above, way above sea level, then I have to have a more weight, okay? I have to have more weights. Now, if you look wherever you're at and whatever your PSI level is, it might say 15. Then again, it might not. It might say 11 pounds. So if we're watching videos and you're wanting to learn how to can, okay, then it's going to be like 11 pounds, 10 pounds. 15 pounds, you need to check your elevation so that way you'll know for sure what it is. And look in your book, your manual, it will also tell you too. But to get that information, go online and check out what is my elevation, put in your zip code, so that way you'll know what you need to have your PSIs on, either it's 11 pounds, 10 pounds, or 15 pounds of pressure. So now, I have put my 15 pounds of pressure on here, and what we're going to do, or what it's going to do, is going to build the pressure in this pot, and this is going to start rocking. You do not set your timer yet until this right here, this weight starts rocking, and I'm going to show you what it looks like and where it needs to be at, because you don't want it to be very vigorous. That's when you have to turn down your heat a little bit, so that way it can rock steady, okay? And I will show you. You want it to rock steady, and it needs to rock so many times a minute, okay? So, it's going to build up its pressure. This is going to begin to rock, and I'm going to show you what that looks like when that comes up to that part, okay? But check your elevation on Google. What is my elevation? And there you will know what it is, so you'll know what you need a pressure can. So when this starts rocking, I'm doing pints, it's gonna be 75 minutes. If I was doing quarts, it would be 90 minutes. So I'm doing my pints. So I'll be back when this is rocking for us to set our timer for 75 minutes. And I'll be back, so stay tuned. Okay, family. So this is the rocking motion that you want it to be. You don't want it to be really vigorous. You don't want it to be any of those things. And if it is, you just need to bring down your heat. So I'm going to pull it down to my sweet spot because I've been doing it for a minute. And you're going to know where it's at too when you start canning, okay? So I got it down to where I need it to be. And it's going to just stay at this little low pace. It's going to move. And then it's going to stop light, and then it's going to circle, and it's going to rock. And that's what it's going to do. And as you see, that's what it's doing. But you're going to turn it down to where it needs to be. You don't want it to be just going really fast like that. You want it to be just like this. So I'm going to set the timer for 75 minutes. And hit start. And it's going to do its processing. And when it's done, I'll be back. Okay, family, time is up. We're going to turn this eye off. And we're going to let it come all the way down from pressure to this everything has stopped moving. This gauge right here will drop. And I'm not going to touch it. Don't you touch it wherever you at. Don't touch it. Don't leave it alone. Wait till it's completely cooled down, okay? You don't want to touch it. And I will catch you back in the next hour when it's completely done and done dropped from the temperature, okay? And we're going to get these jars out then. Stay tuned. Okay, family, time is up. It's been that hour. I'm taking the weight off. And we're going to take off this top. And remember, when you get ready to take your top off, we are going to lift the top away from your face. You don't want to just lift it up because it still will have a little steam in here. So we're going to just remove this away from my face. I'm going to set it down and we're going to take the jars out. Okay, now, so I'm going to remove the jars. So there you have it, family. 8 jars of soup. Beautiful. and it smells so good. So there you have it, y'all. Eight pints, okay? 8 pints of soup. Y'all can do this recipe. I'll have it down in the description below. This is a wonderful recipe. It's so good, so delicious. And I want to thank CAMI. Yes, thank you. Thank you so much for this recipe. I really do appreciate this. So I'm not getting the credit for this. I'm giving her the credit because this was her grandmother's recipe. Her grandmother's recipe. Okay? So she's giving me permission to share this and share it to anyone else who's interested in wanting to have this recipe. Very delicious. Thank you very much, CAMI. Thank you very much. Okay, y'all. So that made 8 pints. And I have some quarts that I have already done so far as well. And then I was able to make 7 quarts. Okay? 7 quarts, 8 pints. And I still had a little bit left over. But I think we're going to eat that. And I'll just make this all over again. Because this is really good, y'all. Y'all will really love it. So, after 24 hours, okay, y'all. Remember, after 24 hours, you'll take those bands off. You will wipe your jars. You will check and see if it's sealed. And the way you can do that is check and see if there's any indention in the middle. If there is an indention, that means it did not seal. If you're able to pick up your jars right at that lid and it doesn't fall on you, then you know it's sealed. Another way you'll know it's sealed is you will hear a tapping noise. If it's not hollow, that will let you know that it did seal if it's not hollow. If it is hollow, that means it didn't seal at all. So, and then the popping noise. That's why I said, check it that way. That's what I do, okay? Because it can seal. It can sound like it's sealed. But if it ain't doing neither one of those things, it just didn't seal. So, as you keep watching the videos, I'm going to be sounding like a robot. Repeat, okay? But I really, really want y'all to get this because I really, really want y'all to be able to can your food up. It is really fun and it's really simple. And you go on Amazon and get that ball book, okay? If you're at Walmart, you can get you another ball book, cookbook. Yes, canning cookbook. So check that out. I'll show you what that looks like. Just give me a second and I'll show it to you. Okay, y'all. So this book here, this is one of the first books I got when I started canning, okay? This book right here. You get all kind of recipes in this book. You can also get all your jams and jellies. All the things are in this book, okay? All of that. Get this book. It's really good. Last year, and even the year before that, I like to can every single thing in this book. I'm not lying. I'm talking about not going to the grocery store. I mean it, just that. I'm not going to the grocery store. You'll be getting the stuff that you need to get in this book. And I guarantee you, if you're not able to have a garden and you go into the grocery store, start learning how to can your food. So that way you can have your own grocery store, okay? Your own grocery store and be able to can everything that's in this book. Look back on some of those videos and I'll be showing you on there. The water bathing, all that. I did a lot of water bathing videos last year and I wanted to make an exception that this year I would pressure can so you could see what I pressure can and how I've been pressure canning. So I showed a whole lot of videos on what was going on here, okay? All from this book, all right? And then the other book is this one. Now, if y'all are up in Walmart and you're in there getting your ball jars, all your canning stuff, look over there. You will see this book. You will, all right? Get this book, y'all. It's very thorough, too. every step, it'll show you how to can. Just like the other book, it'll show you too. This right here is a good book. And I got a few more coming. So start getting these so that way we'll be able to do this together. I'll tell you what page I'm doing. All that. Just get one of the other books. If you can get two at a time, get two at a time. So that way you can see all the things that I'm doing, okay? And that way you can read along and you can be confident and feel good because you're canning your own food. If you like this video, before you go, going back, let me rewind back a little bit. So as far as the sealing of the jars, okay? So after you find out all that is correct, okay? All that's good, is sealed and everything. Then just wipe your jars down, take that band off, right? Put a label on it and what it is and put it up on that shelf and add it to the other collections that you canned, okay? You're going to look back and you're going to be like, I did that. I did that. You know what I'm saying? So, yes, do that. Do that. So, now, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel. Leave a comment down below. And y'all, have yourself a wonderful and blessed day. Bye-bye.